Shalom lekol ha'talmidim ha'talmidot sheli b'kita Aleph. Hi guys, how are you doing? How are you enjoying the weather? It's beautiful. Before you go, you're probably wondering, Mor Michal, what is this video for? This video is to explain you about the summer packets. Are you guys ready? Let's go.
Let me share my screen with you. Over here, I will quickly explain to you about the summer packet. Okay, avoda l'chofesh ha'gadol. So the first page you will see is key. And underneath this first page, you will find control charts. This is a control chart for k'tav letters. You see over here, you have the print, and then you will have the k'tav letter. So this is for us to be able to do one of the page below. And this control chart is for milot yachas, preposition. And there is one more control chart that we will need. It's this control chart. It's the prefixes for Chuvot Chumash. So I printed this and I put it in all of your Chuvot Chumash and sent it home long, long, long time ago. I sent it home with your Haggadah. So if you don't have the control chart, you could go and print this one. It will be attached in the email, in your parents' email. So if you need it, it's here. So you will have this control chart, the k'tav letters, you have the preposition, and you will have the prefixes. And then you reach this page. This page is saying avodah l'chofesh ha'gadol, which means work for summer vacation. Kita aleph, behatzlacha, good luck. So let's see. The first few pages are about Chuvot Chumash. And what you will need for this is the control chart, or if you remember the preposition, the prefixes, that would be great. Okay, so over here it says meha. Mem is from, and ha is the, so from the, and this is how you do the rest of this page. And over here in the bottom you will have word bank. So also this page is from Chuvot Chumash, and you will have in the bottom also a word bank. Let's see, and also here you have word bank. You would need to match this to the numbers, and over here you will need to find the correct answer. So let's see, let's do this together. Behayad, bet is inner with, ha is the, yad means hand. So let's see. So, and the hand, no. To the hand, can't be. I see that I have in or with right here. Which one is the right one? Well, we have the ha. Ha means the. So, can't be C, in a hand. Has to be D, with the hand. Okay, so we did this together. And this is how you do the rest. So, over here, you would write D from, I'm sorry, over here, the first one you would write with the hand. So you write D over here, okay? The next page is also kind of the same thing. You just need to write down the prefixes and translate the words. And over here is also the same thing. And then we get to the page with a kriya text. So what we need to do, we need to read this, and then we need to find three nouns. And how do we symbolize a noun? With a black triangle, nachon, shem etzem, we symbolize it with a black triangle. So we're going to find three nouns and we're going to symbolize them with a black triangle. And then the next page is zachar v'nekeva. So below you will see a lot of objects. Tichatza'it, chulsa, machak, mure. You see a lot of them. And then you need to match which one is a zachar, which one is nekeva. So let's see. They did one example for us. Dugma mean example. So let's see. They wrote machak under zachar. And they wrote chatzait next to nekeva. Friends, do you remember how do we know which one is a zachar and which one is a nekeva? Remember? Et it a is nekeva except for misparim. We look at the nouns and we say, does it end with a et, or with a it, or with an a? If it does, then it means it's nekeva. Okay, so chatzait ends with an eat, and that, therefore, it's nekeva. So you write down the right nouns, the nouns in the correct spot, lecha or nekeva. The next page is writing all the letter in script. Aleph, bet, vet, gimel. So at the top of the Chovot Chumash, you remember that I showed you a control chart of all the letters with their print and their script. So you need to write everything in Ktav, in Ktav letters. And the next page is a Kriya material, the Kriya text, where you need to read this. And then we get to the page about Milot Yachas. You remember what Milot Yachas means? Milot Yachas means preposition. And every time we're going to draw over here, something that corresponds with the preposition. Okay, so let's see the first thing. Ha-tapuach al-ha-kiseh. Tapuach means an apple. So the apple on the chair. So over here, we see a drawing of an apple on a chair. And over here, we see the preposition word that means le-yad. What is le-yad? Oh, if you don't remember, you could go back and see the preposition control chart. So let's see, go to the top, okay? Liyad, over here in my Milot Yachas page control chart, Liyad means next to, next to. So we can draw an object next to. Let's go back to that page. Okay, something next to the chair. So let's say we decide to stay with a tapuach. So we will write ha tapuach, the apple, next to the chair. And over here, we'll draw a picture of an apple next to a chair. So you do the rest of the page. And over here, the last page is about tzvaim. Tzvaim, so you see it vertically, but when you print it, you will work on it horizontally. You would have to print it in order to do this page. So over here it says tzvaim. Tzvaim means colors. So it says tzahov. What does tzahov mean? Tzahov means yellow. It means yellow. A lot of you know the tzvaim. All of you know the tzvaim. Adom means red. So what color do we get when we mix tzahov and adom together? We get, you remember? We get orange, katom. Over here, you color it so you can paint it, or you could color it. You could use crayons or coloring pencil. And this is how you do this page. Okay, friends? So it was my honor to give you a last video before you start your summer.
That's all for today. אני רוצה לאחל לכולם קיץ מהנה ושמח. I want to wish you a wonderful summer. Bye, חברים. I'll miss you.